Well, hello and welcome to the Stadio Nazionale Arc de Triomphi in Bucharest for the final of the World Rugby Under 20 Trophy. The Samoan national anthem. It's time for Fiji, and I'm sure we'll have some challenges as well before kickoff. See what it means to these young men to represent their country. Tears streaming down the face there of Tere Nalangi. Some of the bigger men are always the ones to get a little teary at the start, aren't they? The large guys. It's Fiji. Go for the last high five. It'll be interesting to see if we see the Thimbi from them, their traditional war dance. And of course, Samoa have their Manu as well. Been doing it through the competition. Things can get very emotional here. It's important too for both teams to keep their heads. Great to see the simultaneous challenges. Great part of Pacific and Polynesian rugby, that's for sure. And of course, not just ceremonial. One stage, very real challenges in the past. So the stage is set here at the Stadio Arc de Triomphe in Bucharest, in Romania, who've been great hosts of this World Rugby Under 20 Trophy so far. And it comes down to this, the final between Samoa in blue and Fiji in the white as we wait for the referee to get the kickoff okay here.
Fiji.
So we're underway through the boot of Simon Poliafoa. And there you go. Emotions there, just boiling under the adrenaline, forcing Poliafoa to kick too long and kick out on the full. So good start here for Fiji, good chance for them to get going their attack. See some of these large guys here in the pack there, the tight head prop anchoring the scrum for Fiji on the tight head side here. Nawanawulu, huge man, 120 kgs. He'll be up against the loose head prop for Samoa today, Puatolo. Kuruvoli is the scrum half, the halfback for Fiji.
We need space here, okay? Space.
Referee wants to get the first one right. Such a key here, first scrum for Nawanawulu, to assert his dominance over his opposite.
Crouch! Vine!
So just standing to the left of the scrum, Caleb Munts there.
I give you the mark.
With the black armbands. He's the first five today, and he's got something brewing out there. You can see four of them on the left flank. So, third time lucky perhaps for the scrum.
Crouch! Expand! Vine! Sit!
Oh! Ready to go. Hopefully we'll get the ball in play here. Put a volley. Oh, the scrum splits up and he snipes himself. Good stuff from the scrum half. Fiji going nice and direct in the first couple of phases. But holding on, and a turnover there for Samoa. Well done in the tackle. Maybe just strived for a metre too much there. Lost his support, the Fijian ball carrier. Just deciding what they're going to do. Pupiasi there with the ball. Looks like they've got an early injury here too, Samoa. Very, very stop-start, isn't it? Clock says 2 minutes, but we've had about 10 seconds of play in reality. This is Taliafoa. Of course, can put this ball out. On the full, it's a penalty, and they'll get the line out at the 10-meter line in Fiji territory.
Boys, line is the middle.
Lilu Maiava is the hooker for Samoa. He'll throw the ball in. Oh, and Fiji have disrupted that line out. Well done. Managed to stop Solomona from claiming that one. Midfield this time for Fiji. Kurivoli goes to the right, out to the right wing. It's one of the forwards lurking out there. I think it's Tere Nalangi. Kurivoli, quick ball. It's a little break down there. Not the greatest of passes from Ulu no Kao Bandra, but it's all, this man is the star. Mbotitu, he has been incredible so far this tournament. Mbotitu, watch out for him in the 12 jersey. Just breaks down for Fiji here. Still got possession, what a ball. Even the cameraman missed that one. That's beautiful, here's Turanga Naivalu. From fullback as well, another exciting player. Munts out to midfield to Tere Nalangi. The loose forwards playing here, and they create havoc, these guys. Once they get space, it's just like sevens. Oh, beautiful run. Could it be the first try? It is. First try for Fiji. Mbotitu, we mentioned him just seconds ago. He got two tries against Canada the other day and quite a few assists, and he starts the scoring. But Fiji looking wildly impressive with ball in hand, as you'd expect. All the skills, what an armory they've got out there with loose forwards running rampant. That was number 8, Bomney drove and just slipped the ball into Imbotitu. Looks like Turanga Nivalu will be taking the kicks today. We've had a few guys kicking during the tournament, including Muntz. But it's Turanga Nivalu who starts the kicking account, and what a great start for Fiji. Haven't been the fastest starters in this tournament, that's for sure, Fiji. As Walia Four again goes long inside the 22. Imbotitu, the try scorer, gives it to Muntz. And that's a lovely floating clearing kick. It gets him back to the halfway. Caleb Muntz, who played for Hamilton Boys High School in New Zealand a season ago. Made his name there, but using his Fijian heritage to play international underage rugby. Samoa with a throw, and that's a good take by number four, Mareku. He's their captain. Tolia Four goes wide. Playing a little flatter there, the Samoan team. That's right wing Tupe. Good direct play. It's Kupi Asi. He's a busy little halfback. Asi. A couple of players in the Samoan team with Chinese heritage.
Guys, high tackle number 13. Keep it low.
Kupi Asi at scrum half, and Sioni Yongyen at open side flanker. Feature of Samoan life that the Chinese over the generations from 100 or so years ago, landing in Samoa.
Count it.
Also see some German names crop up from time to time too in Samoa. Lido Maiava, attacking line out here for Samoa. Good play from the captain Moreko. Goes nice and high, but breaks down there with number 8. Fa'a Maisili. Just couldn't hold on to that one. He's a big storming character, Fa'a Maisili. Based in Melbourne and owner, of course, of a beautiful moustache. Could become all the rage now, of course, with Carl Tuinukuafi, the All Black loosehead prop, sporting one of those huge handlebars. So Samoa again, get some line out position. They get to halfway. C goes right this time. Oh, lovely inside ball there to Tupe. And Tolia Four, Asi. Solomono. And again, it's tight forwards out and loose play. Oh, and Patu tried to slip the pass to his teammate, but Imbotito read that one very well. Yes, Tato out to the hooker, lurking down the left flank, Lilo Maiava. I see, surveys his options. Gives it to Solomono. Oh, that's great defense. What a driving tackle there from Mbule, Rocco Mbule. Again, going really low and hard, this Fijian team, making sure of their tackles, as you have to do against the Samoans, that's for sure. Big, strong ball carriers, really direct. You can see the contrast of styles here between the Samoans and the Fijians. The Samoans, they're very, very direct, running straight and hard. Here's that man with his moustache, Fa'a Mausili. Again, great defence. It's Tato. Oh, referee blows that one up quickly. Could have been a little high, perhaps.
No, five.
He's called up Momoi Donu, the Fijian lock.
Number four, white. Just saw the charge, no arms.
Yeah. I think you see number four there, I think. Turagata.
Come here, come with me.
Discipline is
good. Play, so no shoulder, only shoulder, no arms. It's a yellow card.
So. Just check whether that's Turagata.
Captain.
Yes. Turagata. Discipline has been a feature for both of these teams. There's been a rash of yellow and the odd red card in this tournament for the Fijians and the Samoans. It's a very, very physical rugby players. Sometimes those tackles just drifting a bit high and referee are ruling there, no shoulders. So Samoa have a one-man advantage here in the next 10 minutes. Don't make the best of that. Goes over the top too long, but Yong Yen tidies up nicely. Oh, big ball carry there from Hatu. Oh, good turnover though in the tackle. That's Fijian flanker Tiri Nalangi. That's a heads up play from the Fijian flanker at a crucial time. Samoa looking to peg back that 7-0 lead from Fiji. Fiji, of course, one man down now. 10 minutes gone on the final. Here's Muntz, the man we were talking about from Hamilton Boys High. He'd be disappointed following progress from down here in New Zealand. We just had the top four final over the weekend of the secondary schools, and Hamilton Boys High being knocked out in the semi-final by St. Peter's College of Auckland, who the next day got up and beat Napier Boys High 2 for the title. Great run from St. Peter's College. And congratulations to them.
Away 8!
Of course, we're focusing on the under-20s here, the under-20 World Rugby Trophy. And of course, the winner of this game gets to go to Argentina next year for the under-20 Rugby World Championship with the big boys. France, of course, the champions this year earlier in June. It's great to see them get up, beat the Kiwis, Aussies and the English on their road to the final. And really looking forward over the next few years to see how Les Bleus develop with all those fantastic young players that they had on that team. Building, of course, to the World Cup in 2023. And, of course, the earlier edition next year in Japan. Oh, that's going to be an exciting one. So Fiji, with possession. Here's Miti Prop, Nathiva. Oh, good run from Nathiva. Really taking it to the opposition and getting the legs going too. Nice work from the prop. Now here's where Fiji are dangerous, isn't it? Phase play.
Hi, number 10. Yeah. Hi.
Well, that's good play, one man down from Fiji. Just owning the ball, and Samoa again. Just infringing that offside line. So Fiji, of course, happy to slow it down. Can he play from the Fijians when you've got a man in the sin bin? Of course, you want to sap up as much of that 10 minutes as you can. And so a penalty is a chance for 3 points, but also a chance to just sap up a minute or so of the clock. Turanga Nivalu, he's been successful with that conversion earlier. And so far this tournament, he's had 5 conversions and 1 penalty, alongside 2 tries. I'll make that 6 conversions, of course, with the one he's had earlier today. Oh, he's hit that nice and high. had plenty of length on it, but just missed with the radar drifting to the left. Well, if you're the Samoan coach here, the message to your players certainly is make the most of this next 7 or 8 minutes. One man down the Fijians, they need to make those numbers pay. That's a great restart, but again, the ball's popped to nobody in particular. It's Fui Ono wearing the number 24 jersey. So Fiji with a chance. Oh, big defence, hammer time there from the Samoans. Oh, and you could see that coming. It was a Bongi Dro who got that one. And so Samoa here with a chance. And that could be a big psychological blow there too with the Samoans. Physical. There'll be little peaks going on. Here's McNamara.
Number one!
Nice driving play there from Marefa, the captain.
There's a knock on by White.
Moreko, he's been around already, he's played to a reasonably high standard. Played for Samoa A earlier this year in the Pacific Challenge. And that sort of open grade rugby. Pretty good level for a 19, 20 year old to be playing.
I'll watch his bind.
So one man down, set piece. There's going to be a gap here somewhere. Fiji packing down a 7-man scrum, no number 8. So perhaps some will even put a bit of pressure on here and get a penalty in front of the posts. You can see it's all go forward for Samoa. Control important. Here's number 8. Fa'amausili gets it left. Oh, beautiful footwork there from the 12, Fetu. Asi goes in. Gets it Solomona with a nice straight run. Asi goes again to number 12, Fetu. Good defence there, though, from Turanga Novalu. Samoa just need to retain the composure. Good clean-up work there from Fa'a Malsilu. Again, a turnover here. Disappointing for Samoa. Not holding the ball and getting that possession. It's off Muntz with a beautiful break. Running like a hare. He gets smashed but manages to get the ball away. Little knock on though. And Muntz felt that tackle. Just down on his haunches taking a breather. It showed some pace there too, Caleb Muntz. Samoan really need to hold on to the ball here. They were making good inroads into Fiji territory, but just simple mistakes and good pressure from the defence of Fiji as well. As it looks like number 8, Bongi Dro, is down. Just talking about the road to the finals for these two teams. Fiji beating Uruguay 55 points to 34.
Let's go, guys. What is up?
A win over Portugal 32-22. Then taking on Canada, and that was a good win against Canada 53-26. Pretty even. Canada had the lead up till about 15 minutes to go, and Fiji just worn them away. And the heat too probably got to Canada after a while, I think. Fiji going away easily in the end, winning 53-26.
Bind. Set.
Pupiasi, the scrum half for Samoa. Poliafoa, switch ball to a crashing wing, Tato. Not easy there for RC, and I think there'll be a penalty. Yes, there was quite a bit of traffic in the back of that ruck, including Ulu Nakalvandra. For Fiji, the open side flanker, making a nuisance of himself. Patu makes that one up. Tolio Lafoa. I see, he's been a good link man, the scrum half. So they get it wide. Forward pass again, simple mistake. Solomona from Fiji.
Oi, enough.
Yong Yen there, the hand on the headgear, just chirping away at the pass. Perhaps giving his opinion. of the skill level of Solomon. I don't see that.
The captain?
Well, the referee's...
Come here, make your team back.
He's setting a level here, isn't he? He's going to be quite strict.
Come here. You're playing an awesome game. And I think the behavior should stay there. Up. So we cannot lose focus here. It's a forward pass. So speak to your players. No pointing, no hoo-hoo. Understand? You speak to them, and then we'll have a scrum here. Yeah?
Referee just laying down the law, and it's true too, this is a showcase of the game and we don't want any silliness. It's become a bit of a part of the game in the last 12 months, hasn't it, with the, when there's an error, the old patting on the back or the head of the opposition players, but a showmanship which isn't really rugby, let's face it. It's a gentleman's game, played by gentlemen.
Here's the mark, it's a forward pass by Blue.
So after the lecture, we'll pack a scrum down just outside the Fiji 22.
Crouch.
Halfway through the first half, Fiji leading 7-0 for a try. If you just joined us through Mbotitu, converted by Turanga Nivalu.
Give him space.
Oh, that's a good scrum from Samoa. Of course, they've got a one-man advantage, but Fiji managing to get that out through Kutavoli. Months again, breaking the line. Hunts, he's a brave young man. He's not the largest player there, you'll see him. Caleb Munts. Taking some hits, that's for sure. Good crowd here at the Stadio Archi de Triomphi, which translates, I guess, into the French equivalent of Arc de Triomphe. Romania, of course, playing great hosts here for the World Cup Under 20 trophy. Once a genuine powerhouse of rugby, Romania, through their army. And hopefully they can reach similar heights in the near future as well. Fiji on attack here, Kuravoli. Gets it wide, the loose forwards again in play for Fiji. They're a tough prospect to tackle. Kuravoli again goes into the ruck. This time it's Derelangi. Good defence from Samoa.
The ball is there. The ball is available. Wait.
Bit of volleys there. He's got a pot of tighties there, the tight forwards. Natiba saw a great run from him earlier. Oh, that's a beautiful run. Straight through the heart of the defence. It's Derelangi. The blindside flanker. In fact, it's Turanga Nivalu. Well, I saw number 6 on the back of that jersey in the headband, but it's Turanga Nivalu. Ran from deep, and what wonderful play from the Fijians. They're one man down, and Kuravoli running a little dummy line off the ruck. Inside ball. Obviously screened for it. And this is fantastic play from the Fijians. One man down. Now two tries up.
Everything good?
Conversion, no problem for Turanga Nivalu, and that brings his points total for the tournament to 30. He's been a good contributor for Fiji.
On the line outs, just wait for the ball to be popped.
Well, this is an important time for Samoa here. They really need the reply to stay in this game and to make the most of the one man advantage. And that's not a great kick from Collier 4. His restarts haven't been the best. Of course, put the kick off straight into touch on the full. Just goes to show nerves can take a huge part of this game.
through that. Come here, boys. Come here, boys.
Let's see Fa'amal Sili, number 8 there, trying to rally these Samoans into action.
Crouch. Set.
Well, that's a sloppy scrum. So Samoa here with the bit between their teeth. They've been getting inside the 22 okay, just after three or four phases, having a little trouble retaining possession. Need to probably commit just a few more men to the ruck and the breakdown. So poor Tolo, again, can run straight and direct and simple, but a little knock on again. Just the basics going awry there for the Samoans. Well, it's been a great day of rugby here in Bucharest. Just giving you some of the earlier results. Canada beating Romania 71-14 for the 7th and 8th playoff. So Canada beating the hosts there. Reasonable tournament for them. Uruguay pushing back the challenge of Hong Kong 78-17 for 5th and 6th. And Portugal over Namibia, 67-36, and high-scoring games earlier today in the third and fourth playoff. Good tournament for Portugal. Of course, last year they reached the final against Japan, going down only 14-3. So interesting to see where rugby development is taking place the most. And the Portuguese really coming into their own, which is good. So a third place position for them this year. Congratulations to them.
Mine.
Free kick awarded by the referee, so Kutavoli takes it quickly. And Samoan starting to fall off the tackles too. Less aggression in that defensive phase. And that's a good run though from Fetu. Sapaya Fetu. Cognizant that he needs the support again. The ball slipped away from his hands. Another turnover for Samoa. I make that 6 or 7 turnovers on attack for the Samoans. You just can't give up that many chances as Imbotitu flips a little ball that was slightly forward. And the Samoans, maybe, you know, with the heat and the sweat on the jerseys, the ball's slightly slippery, but the Samoans really need to get that area of their game under control.
Time is off.
Referee getting a call from perhaps the assistant referee here.
You good? You good?
Checking out an injured player. So we told you about the Fijian road to the final. Let's just check Samoa's results. They beat Hong Kong first up 41-20. Hong Kong been reasonable in this tournament too. Good to see them coming through. The senior team, of course, doing very well in the repechage action for the World Cup next year. And a good result at the Asian Games Sevens last week as well. Then Samoa beat Romania, the host, 31-17, and Namibia 41-28. That was their road to the final. So they're an impressive team, the Samoan team. Of course, fourth game in quick succession over 10 days, so that takes its toll as well. As RC puts the ball into this attacking scrum, Samoa, important for them to get a score here. Tolia 4. So Faze's options goes deep out to the fullback Fuione. Fuione, apologies. RC again distributing midfield this time. Again, just slightly late to the breakdown there. And they've got numbers here out to the right. A chance. Here's Patu. This bulky lock forward. Did he need to throw the pass? He did. And the right wing out there, Tupe, collected the ball. And a flying defender. He can't be there. right in the ribs, so it's not great for Tupac. Yeah, just in review, perhaps that ball from Patu didn't need to throw it. Miracle ball, could have gone to ground and had some real front foot ball going.
Okay, after I speak to him. Come here.
Love to see a replay of that because it was a fantastic tackle. Nothing illegal about it, just a nice solid hit. But of course, Tupa had to reach up for that ball, exposing his ribs. Never a great feeling when you're a rugby player and you get what we used to call the hospital pass up above your head. And you extend those arms up and leave the midriff exposed.
I'll have a look.
Some people, of course, decide discretion is part of valor and just let the ball float over the head to the next player in the line if there's one. But of course, Tupe, the right wing, it was either going to him or going out. So brave from Jim Tupe. Also an injury over there to Nathiwa, Fijian prop. Reasonably warm here, of course, late summer, early autumn. A bit steamy.
Open up, Lou.
All right, someone need to put some real acid on this Fijian line-out. They're giving away a few centimetres in height, the Samoans, but good technique in the right lift here. You can see the captain, Noreko, has taken it upon himself to try and get up and challenge. In fact, number 8, Tufao Masili. So Samoa here, they get it through Lilo Maiaba.
Away three.
Time to score here for Samoa. Yong Yen. Asi clears it from the ruck. Oh, lovely ball from Solomona. But again, just a little bit, fraction late to the tackle. Really, really sad for Samoa there. It was a good run. He set up a nice target, but the Fijian defenders just over the top before the Samoans can clear away. You really need to look at that. There needs to be some urgency at the breakdown. Months. Clears nicely. Hope you're enjoying this coverage from World Rugby, the final of the Under 20 Trophy. Mike Rehu bringing you the action. Certainly an honour and a pleasure to bring this game with two exciting teams from the Pacific playing off for the trophy and of course the right to go to the Under 20 World Champs next year. Omoi Dono there with a little action in midfield, and here is where it's dangerous. This is Vudongo. He's been very quiet, but he's got himself a try in each of the games so far. Vudongo, the centre, played a bit of wing earlier on in the tournament as well. Oh, another piece of magic from the Fijians. And of course it's Turanga Nivalu who's involved again. A dummy pass out to the open, and the fullback scoots down the side. Very clever, very inventive. Mbotito dropped the ball, but it didn't matter. Samoa offside. So referee just reminding Noreko, the captain there, about the laws in this under 20 grade. In the open play, of course, anywhere below the neck seems to be acceptable, but under 20 they've been playing this the nipple law, so all the tackles must fall under the nipple level of the chest, which is sensible from World Rugby. It's good to see. Because it does seem all too easy for those tackles around upper chest level to slip up with the momentum of the defender and the player around the head, so I think that's a pretty good law that maybe they could carry through. Head injuries becoming one of the major talking points of the game. And player safety, of course, paramount. Interesting they take the points here to get themselves out beyond two converted tries, and it's Turanga Nivalu. He's been outstanding so far today, hasn't he? straight and true for Turanga Nivalu.
Yep.
Penalty to go with his try and two conversions. So he's feasting today. He's got 12 points out of the 17 for Fiji. And we just talked about that snipe down the blind a couple of minutes ago. His try coming in too on a dummy angle from the deep, really involving himself from fullback. Bongi Drow gets it to Turanga Nivalu. It's right wing over on the left flank, Mbule. Oh, it's just magical to watch these Fijians in open play, isn't it? Of course, majestic sevens performers, Olympic gold medalists and Rugby World Sevens, the open men, and just genuine entertainers the world over, and you can see that talent carrying through. Play with so much belief in their skills, their passing, their handling. Physically, they're incredibly imbued, aren't they? Long, live athletes, can run at pace, can smash people hard. Asi. So they go wide this time, Samoa. Here's Fuiono. Tato. It's taken. Fa'amausili in midfield. I see again then quickly. He realizes he's got to clear that ball. That's better play from Samoa. At least they're getting men to the breakdown. Oh, and again, the ball's dropped. And they swoop on it, the Fijians here. Ooh! Fiono gives his coach a scary moment there, juggling the ball. That could have been an intercept try. But the Samoans continue their attack. This is Yong Yen again. Just gets isolated. Manages to get the ball back to Tato. Penalty here for Samoa. And they take it quickly through RC. Could have thought about the line out there, closer to the try line.
No, seven! Stay boys, stay boys.
Switch play, Mareko, the captain, drops it. Fa'o Mausili's there to support. Here's Yong Yen, dummies, but Deri Nalangi's having none of that. Tackles him strongly. Fa'o Mausili. He's been dominant in midfield, Fa'o Mausili, but just needs more support. Poor Tolo, the referee's let that one go, and he's playing advantage here for Samoa. He's kept a firm hand on this game, the referee, hasn't he?
Put the ball down.
Wants to have another chat.
You're raising the tackle line. No more, okay? Careful with the shoulder. Use your arms all the way. Another one can go. That one. Yeah. High tackle. Yeah.
Yeah. Fijian captain. Momoi Dono.
Shot.
Well, interesting decision, isn't it? Samoa deciding to go for the points just before half-time here. Just get some points on the board, important for the psychological battle. So hopefully Toliafoa can convert the 3 points. It's been good so far in the tournament. 2 tries against Hong Kong, 4 conversions and a penalty against Namibia. A try, 3 cons. 32 points so far in the tournament for Simon Toliafoa. Again, another first 5'8 who spent some time in Auckland, New Zealand. He was at De La Salle College in Auckland. And that's a good kick from Toliafoa. Making the score 17 points to 3 on the cusp of half time. Just a couple of minutes to go. So, will that give Samoa a spur, hopefully. Mbotitu decides to go long inside the 22 here. Picked up on the run from Paku. But again, a simple error from Samoa. Really let them down their hands in this first half. So Fiji with a chance for another try just before half-time. Mbotitu switches to Vudongo.
Stay, boys! No!
Down the left flank this time. Derinalangi gets his hands on the ball.
No!
5 metres out here, Fiji. Close to prop, Natiba. He's strong with ball in hand. And they're rumbling this one. Bongi Dro.
No hands!
Good physical play. It's that man again, Turangani Balu. He's got a good combination with Kuravoli, that's for sure. Options left and right here for Rocco Mbuli. Mbil Potitu decides to go inside. Muntz has to help him out. Kuravoli gets hammered in the tackle, but Fiji still have the ball. That's been the difference between the two teams, retention. Oh, Vudongo does really well, struggles just a couple of metres away, and it's a try in the corner, I think, to the lock. Kudagata, the man who was Simbin midway through the first half. And a bit of redemption there for the lock, Mali Turagata. Yeah, referee awards the try. And this is an important score for Fiji just before half-time. Taking advantage again of Samoan handling errors. And phase upon phase of attack, relentless against the Samoan wall of blue. And in the end, out wide, there was a gap for Mali Turagata. Well, you don't want to say it's a bridge too far before half time, but
15.
That is a very important try. And of course, there's an old adage in rugby, who's got to take it right on the sideline. Be able to give them a couple of centimetres inside the field of play, you'd think, but why not? There's a challenge.
Guys, just give me time.
Cameraman getting nice and intimate there with a kick. Good work from our crew, World Rugby. Should get a good angle of this one as Turanavilu kicks the ball. Oh, didn't go to it in the end. Floats to the right there, Turanganivalu. Can't be long to play in this first half. Fiji with the lead, 22 points to 3. Natalia 4. We'll want to get this one right. He's had a couple of fluffs. Kickoff time. That's a good one, though. Mbotitu, he's featured strongly in play there inside centre for Fiji. Taking some great options, and here we go again. Turanganivalu. Oh, and the ball's popped up from Tira Patterson. Almost his first touch of the game. He coughed it up. Yeah, like a furball, didn't he?
No, four!
Tolia four with a counter-attack chance here.
Stay, no one!
I see. You can tell those Fijian tackles have taken a toll. The Samoans certainly not as assertive as they were with ball in hand earlier on. Flying into the tackles. Again, handling errors. Doesn't matter though. Samoa get themselves a penalty, not rolling away. Okay. I think the issue for the Samoans is too that the Fijians have, throughout this tournament, been very strong in the last 15 minutes. So really need to get back towards parity here near half-time, the Samoans. Fix the handling, fix the breakdown area. And they're settling with a shot here. Mariko. Toliafoa. Inside ball on the crash there is Fetu. Eventually gets taken down on the 10-meter line. Here's Solomona. He's good with ball in hand. Solomona. Flat pass out wide. Inside the 22 now.
Away now, Blue!
Turangani Valu does well there to tie that one up for Fiji. Safe play from them. Months again. Some good maturity in the Fijian team, that's for sure. And a man down there for Fiji. A little back injury by the looks. Again, four games in quick succession, taking a bit of a toll on the players. Good test of fitness. That's Yong Yen getting a bit of treatment. The open side flanker. He's been annoying at the breakdown, as every good open side flanker should be. Sioni Yong Yen. Kuravoli puts a high ball in here. Oh, and it's taken advantage of too by Kuravoli. Puts in a little chip kick down inside the 22 for Samoa. Fuioni on his back. Will there be time for this play before half time? As if there is.
Time or not?
BGM with a chance. The referee's just asking. A little bit of uncertainty about how much time left to play. The Fox is 39.
30 seconds, boys. 30 seconds. 30 seconds.
So Fiji have a chance here.
Just go back. 10.
To go one more step towards victory just before half time. Oh, that goes short. Clever little play.
5 meters.
Samoa decided to take it quickly.
5 meters, not 5.
Oh, it's a free kick. It didn't go 5 meters, the ball, into the line out. So Samoa. Last chance saloon in this first half, at least. Patu with ball in one hand like an NBA player. We've got a long way to go to get a five-pointer here. That if any team could do it, it's Samoa. But again, eyes not on the ball.
Leave it, boys, leave it.
That time it was from Captain Mareko, I think. Basics going awry for Samoa. They're going to get a bit of a stern talking to, I think, in the changing shed, Samoa. They've certainly got the ability to win this Under 20 World Rugby Trophy final, but just some simple errors mean that they're 22-3 down at the break. 3 tries to none for Fiji. We'll see you soon for the second half here from Bucharest. So players back for the second half in this World Rugby Under 20 Trophy final. You can see there the scoreline 22 points to 3 to Fiji after the first half. 3 tries to nil. There's one of the try scorers, Mbotitu who scored the first try with the ball in hand. Then it was the Turangalivalu show, got himself a conversion, a beautiful try, running an amazing line off halfback Kuravoli. And just before half time, Turagata, the man who was sinbinned, yellow carded in the first half, part of the first half with a try. And a penalty for good measure in there too from Turangalivalu. 22 points to 3. Sole points coming from the boot for Samoa of Toliafoa with a penalty. So Samoa with a lot to do here. There's Patu, who's been good with ball in hand, the lock. Solomona also, two of their main ball runners, getting their hands on the ball first up in the second half. A lot of work to do here for Samoa. It's not beyond them though. They've proven they're a solid team. Just need to concentrate on the basics. Pass and catch. Clean outs at the ruck. Batu and Asi getting around the fringes there, and the referee letting them. That'd be a call there, I think, for offside around the side of the ruck. Or is it a high tackle he's playing advantage for? Anyway, Fiji have the advantage here, and they'll get the penalty. Another high tackle. That's been a feature too. The referee's been very stringent on that, as he should. Here's Muntz, first 5-8. Also been good, taking some great options in the first half, Muntz. Him and Mbotitu in midfield. Really running the cutter for Fiji and making some good choices. Especially after two or three phases, a lot of these teams, the drill will only get you so far. You set up your pods, you go back and forth, right to left. But then when it breaks up, that's where the Fijians really come into play. Just so intuitive with their play. Mbotitu makes a break. Muntz gets it wide to Turangalivalu. New blood on the field there by the looks of it. It's Rada Tambua, the 19 jersey. See who he's replaced at the first set piece. Could be actually Turagata, I think, the man who scored the try just before half time. Can you see a number 4 jersey out there? I don't think I can, so it's probably who Rada Tambua has replaced. Fiji a chance to open their account in the second half. Conservative there from Muntz, but he gets the ball out about 12 metres from the try line. Will they go for a drive here? Looks like they've had a little team talk, so expect maybe a rolling maul here. Good secure ball from Didi Nalangi. Now there it goes. Splinters off. Yong Yen's got his hands on the ball. Oh, it pops up this time outside of Fijian ruck. So chance for Samoa to relieve some pressure here. Asi goes to Toliafoa. He manages to get the ball out and over the hoardings as well. So no quick throw in there for Fijian wing. It's Patterson on the right side.
Go 10.
This would be a statement if Fiji can make the first score of the second half as well. It's going to make it extra hard for Samoa to come back from this. Momo Dono gets the line-out take. Here's Budongo. Goes down on a hefty tackle, the centre. Muntz, nice technique, just dragging his opposite to ground. Samoa go wide this time. Oh, but sadly, poor Tolu out there, he can't grab the ball, but Mbotitu can, and he's away. It will be the first try of the second half for Fiji, and it's Mbotitu alongside Turangalivalu. They have been so influential in this game, and if we were going to choose a man of the match at the end of this, Those two would be up in contention already. Quick as a flash, good skills, picking the ball up at pace on the run, off the ground, and a good try to Mbotito. It's the Hong Kong lads consuming some beverages post-match and post-tournament, of course. That's been good play from them. Shout out to all of the Hong Kong rugby community. Some very passionate people there. Of course, they've had the sevens for 40-odd years, but the 15s really starting to burgeon as well. They've got some academies going as Kuranga Nivalu gets the conversion. It's great to see some of the local players from Hong Kong too coming through the ranks. Leofor restarts, goes a bit centre field this time. Nothing the Fijians can't handle though. You sense they've got a real confidence now. Oh, the numbers down the left too. The pass just slipping forward there. Once they get the bit between the teeth, Fiji as well. It's entertaining to watch, but not so much fun if you're on the defensive side of things. Just for this game, I'd love to see Samoa get a try here. Just give themselves some confidence.
Guys, not good enough. Both teams engaging. Keep the space. Crouch!
The halfbacks, Pupi Asi. Got himself a try against Romania earlier in the tournament. He'd love another one, I'm sure. Very untidy scrum times, isn't it? And Fiji really putting some pressure on there on the front rows. Not easy for poor Tolo, the loose head prop, and McNamara here on the tight head side, joined by Lilo Mayaba at hooker. So it is McNamara and Nativa. They're called out.
Hips needs to be, your shoulder needs to be,
Always love it when the 70 kilo ref schools up the 120 kilo props about scrummage. Of course, they know the laws brilliantly, the referees, and they know what is needed to avoid penalties.
Fine. Set.
See, good quick ball. But again, he's penalised McNamara there on the tight head, I think. Just going down. The refs would have let that go. The ball at the back of the scrum, ready to be recycled. But you can sense that the Samoan scrum was under pressure. And those resets. Don't just blame the tight head prop McNamara either. A lot of the work has to come from the guys behind, the locks, Hatu and Mareko, the blindside flanker Solomono. He needs to get in there and make sure he's supporting that prop.
Block him, block him. Five.
Hope you're enjoying this stream.
Come on.
Coming to you on YouTube and Facebook. Had some comments during the first half. Some pretty passionate supporters out there of these two teams, which is great to see. Fiji bumped off there. Dere Nalangi still going. Meter from the line. Strong play from Dere
Nalangi.
Kudavoli goes blind. Goes himself. Gets there too. Kudavoli. adding to his try against Canada that he got earlier in the tournament. And that's well deserved from the scrum half, Kudavoli. Just see here, he weighed up his options, looked way left. You could see Turanga Nagalu there. He just drew some of the defence eyes away from himself. And scurried over. Good halfback play there from Kudavoli. Getting to almost blowout stage in this final. We've seen some big scores today. Some teams playing some of their players who maybe didn't get a start earlier on in this tournament. Just give you those scores again. Canada over Romania 71-14. So Canada 7th in the tournament. Uruguay taking 5th over Hong Kong 78-17. And Portugal 67, Namibia 36 in the third and fourth playoff. So almost 100 points a game so far in those last games. And Turanga Nivalu misses one. That's rare. So 34 points to 3. That's a good kickoff, allowing his team to compete. Fiji showing good skills at the restart. Up nicely. Again, watch the phases of attack here from Fiji. The tight forwards taking the first couple up. They get close to the touchline, managing to stay in. That's two phases. They'll come to midfield with another pod. In fact, they go wide already, months. Got behind the advantage line though, but some nice footwork and a penalty.
No.
And you can see the assistant referee in the background talking Captain. To the referee.
Captain, that's the second.
The referees will be aware too that sometimes with a scoreline like this there'll be a bit of frustration from the team in blue as well. They need to ensure that nobody gets too angry. Ike Nivere, he put the ball into this lineout. You see the good crowd we've had here today, which is good. Hopefully this will go some way to regrowing rugby in Romania. Turanga Nivalu, it's well put to ground there from Samoa. Good tackle. Months. Ball under pressure, but does well. Fiji have a few numbers out right too if they want to continue the attack out there. Kudavoli, he's a canny player. Mbotitu, and here are those numbers. It's becoming Nivere.
Oh, no!
Man off his feet there, the replacement player, Massa. Sefaliafanga, 20, just off his feet, still struggling to get the ball back, needed to get his hands off there. Sefaliafanga, Joe. Well, they look well composed, this Fijian team, don't they? Certainly. Look good enough to go up a level. They played earlier this year in the Oceania Under-20s tournament, a tournament featuring New Zealand, Australia and Tonga. And losing to New Zealand and Australia, but beating Tonga 54-0. So, oh, that's a great drive from Fiji. They're 5 metres away from the line again. Power and flair. What a mixture. Oh, and
double roll. It's a penalty offside.
Okay, so the try's disallowed double roll. but they were playing advantage for offside. Fiji will have the penalty.
Offside.
Put a volley once quickly. Scrum, he's suggesting maybe to Monks. Yep. So set play here from Fiji. Scrum is looking solid. We're back in May in the Oceania tournament. Fiji beating Tonga 54-0.
Set.
Even space, no? Stay safe.
Kuruvoli. Flat ball to Mbotitu. It's left wing off his wing, Patterson. Could be easy here for Fiji. Oh, good defence. That's Tato there.
Blew away.
Coming off the wing, good stiff defence. Kuruvoli out wide this time, and Mbotitu's put it down. Chance to counter. Here's Solomona. Well, they're determined, this Samoan team. Good on them. Pushing back the challenge there of Fiji, and a chance of the ball in hand. And here's space out in the left wing too. It's Fui Ono out there though. Fiji with Tere Nalangi still with ball in hand, so composed as he gets himself to ground as well for the recycle. Wide pass to Mbotitu. Yong Yen. And here's Vudongo. Patterson. In fact, it's Rocco Mbuli out there. He's still going. Couldn't put him down. The right wing on the left flank this time. Rocco Mbuli. And what a run. Beat four or five defenders. Hands on hips for the Samoans. They're tired and they're frustrated. No answer to this Fijian flair and power. Watch this run from Rocco Mbuli. One, two, three. Gets the legs driving and over in the fourth tackle in the corner. That is a brilliant individual try from Rocco Mbuli. It's just good to see the Fijian team playing with the mixture of orthodoxy, and then when the moments allow, the flair takes over and they're irrepressible the way they're playing. Here as Turanga Nivalu tries to convert the sixth try of Fiji today. Gives it a good nudge too, just slightly to the left. Scoreline 39 points to 3.
Number 5.
Just trying to total up all these tries. So one to Turanga Nivalu, one to Rocco Mbuli, two to Mbotitu, one to Kuruvoli, the scrum half, and one to the lock, Turagata. Six tries. Three of them converted, and one penalty for Turanga Nivalu. Still got plenty of time here to play too. New blood on the field for Samoa. It's Liovasa. Samoa look great with ball in hand. They just need to be a little patient sometimes going through the phases. It's Captain Moreko. Solomona, he's been brave too. So again, some space out here. Can they convert a bit of pressure into some points? Solomona. He hasn't stopped trying all day, taking it to the Fijians, that's for sure. again. Let's not panic, Samoa. Let's just keep going. McNamara there with good skills. But there's a drop ball. Lucky playing advantage. A little high again. Interesting to see the under 20 teams pan out. Of course, the Six Nations up north, they have an under 20 tournament every winter, so that'll be coming up in the next couple of months, building their teams towards the under 20 tournament that's held in June next year in Argentina. Fiji look like they are going to make their way to the tournament, and of course the Southern Hemisphere always strong. New Zealand, Australia, South Africa have all had their moments in the under 20 level in the last few years. In New Zealand this week, playing an under 19 tournament that's basically a selection tournament for the under 20 team next year. First round played already, Bay of Plenty. Canterbury doing very well. And the finals will be next Saturday for that under 19 tournament in New Zealand. Some great talent coming through.
Bye. Set.
Months. He's gone to scrum half. Kutavoli looks like he's taking a spell. And Botitu at first receiver now. Charge down. Good Kenny play from Months. Knew that he wasn't offside with a charge down. Grabs the ball. Grabs position for Fiji. Long Yen playing halfback this time. Budongo slips a lovely ball to Patterson. Now it's Samoa. Toliafoa. Again, the ball didn't need to be thrown. Oh, it's frustrating. It wasn't even a 50-50 ball from Toliafoa. He had two defenders to get over to get that ball inside to his teammate.
Okay. I'll watch it. He has the flag. I'm speaking to him. Okay, just go.
Back. Looks like we may have some disciplinary action on the run here. Assistant referee with his flag out. Just look at that tackle from maybe on Toliafoa.
I haven't seen nothing. For 15. High or just late? Late, but then high. I'll give a warning. Captain and number 15. This is a warning for you guys. There is two high tackles and then one late tackle here. Next one.
Yosifatu Moreko. Vakabula Momoidonu there, just receiving some advice from the referee. A little late. So Samoa with a chance for their first try at this final.
Just wait.
World Rugby Under 20 Trophy up for grabs. Fiji with just over 10 minutes to go, 39 points to 3 lead. Certainly one hand on the trophy, that's for sure. McNamara is subbed. He's had a good day, McNamara. He's managed to anchor the scrum that hasn't been the most powerful for Samoa, so now Nasaroa comes on.
Come on. Knock on my way.
So a bit of a reprieve there for Samoa. Knock on at the line out. Let's see if Nasaroa can help scrum time here, the new man at Typhoon Prop.
Ismail.
Looks like there's more reinforcements coming as well. Poor Tolo's day at the office is over. And Onile comes on. Pepe Taise. Onile always already on at hooker. It's a brand new front row here for Samoa.
Bind. Set.
He's given a warm welcome at scrum time, that's for sure, by Nafiva. His replacement scrum half, Ma. Again, Samoa with a nice string of penalties here. They take it quick. Good defense from Fiji, though. Samoa, they need to get it wide here, I think. Oh, that's a good run from Faliopanga, though. Left this time, close to the posts. Samoa, some good cleaning out there, too, from their new men off the bench. Now they go wide. Faliopanga, oh, he could see the gap there, too. Just held by the bootlaces by Yong Yen. Well, here's a series of penalties. Surely the referee must think yellow here. Three or four penalties in a row. I think if I was Captain Yosifatu Noreko, I'd be asking the referee how many more infringements need to happen before the yellow card's brandished at the Fijians. They played very well, the Fijians, and they're probably, after the game against Canada, just had a talk about starting, hitting the ground running. It took them a while to wear down Canada, that's for sure. Canada with about 15 minutes to go with the lead, but Fiji with a string of three or four tries in the last 10, 15 minutes, making sure of the victory. Samoa go for their first try of the day. Toliafoe is dragged down. It's a knock on, but again, another penalty. So here we go.
Number 11, I tackle, okay?
Looks like Patterson might be in a bit of trouble, yep.
High tackle.
Tira Patterson is yellow carded for a high tackle. So Samoa with a one-man advantage. They had it in the first half, conceded 10 points. They really want to make the most of this next 10 minutes.
It's okay, but I'll watch it, yeah?
Solomon has moved from blind side flanker to number 8, I reckon. He should take it off the back himself, have a go. He's certainly got the power. Just need the scrum to be steady. It's a good scrum for Samoa. There he goes, Solomon. Oh! Well, I called it, didn't I? But the referee had other ideas.
You did? Okay, sorry.
And he's not too happy either, Shama Anthony Solomona. It's a good positive scrum from Samoa. They got the push on, the first push on. And that meant that the path was clear to the try line for Solomona there off the back of the scrum. Sometimes I just don't understand why the referee wouldn't let something like that go, let the ball go out of the scrum. Resets are no good for anybody. Nobody's in danger.
Fine.
The free kick. Here's Solomon. Take two. Go, Shama Anthony.
Oh, wait.
Tied up this time. A meter away from the line. Faliafanga has a go. They go wide. Here's second 5-8 Fetu. He's been strong with ball in hand, too, Fetu. Just hasn't had the chances, probably. To be fair, quick succession of ball here for Samoa. Well, a hand from Fiji goes over the top. Just a knock on there. It wasn't on purpose, that's for sure. He was wrapping his arms around the Samoan ball carrier. There's a few broken bodies as we enter the last stanza of this tournament. Well, it's always tough. I'm sure a few of you have played tournament rugby. Well, you're playing a game every two or three games, days. And it can wear you down after a while, that's for sure, the knocks and the collisions. So some of those players just, their body's perhaps saying enough. That's a prop, Makeva, down on the ground, and he's had a good game today. And very strong.
Around 10.
Manuel Nativa. Notice his boots there. He's got an orange one on the left and a green one on the right. Don't know if that's for the technique of the loose head prop or luck, or he's just brought a mix of boots to the ground by mistake today. Or maybe it's a fashion statement. Who doesn't want odd boots? Orange on the left and green on the right. And the fever there.
Fine. Guys, this one needs to be sorted. By the way, I will.
But of course, sometimes you're talking technically for props. Different feet do different jobs in the scrum. That outer leg really laying down the foundation of the whole pack. So maybe he's got longer springs on that orange boot. Wouldn't surprise me. You see just the left leg there splayed outwards a little bit. So it's Solomona. Gives the ball to Ma. Again, it breaks down for Samoa. I feel so sorry for them. They've had their chances, the Samoans, and just haven't had anything come their way. The rub of the green hasn't been great for them, but also they do need to look at themselves, and I'm sure they know they're good solid rugby players, these Samoans. They'll be aware that the clean out wasn't great. They let the Fijians in over the ball, and just simple handling errors let them down as well. So can't win every game, that's for sure. And they're staring down the barrel of their first ever defeat at World Cup trophy level. They've been a team that spent a lot of time at the champs as well as the trophy. Nice floated ball from Mbotitu. He's been good. Vodongo as well. Worked in tandem in the midfield. And who would your player of the day be? Any ideas? Just post it on Facebook in the comments section. Let's take a look at who you think should be player of the day. Would it be Mbotitu with his two tries and a couple of assists? The number 12 for Fiji. Turanga Nivalu, perhaps. He's kicked well, he's set people up, got a try of his own. Put a volley, was good at the base of the scrum half. Of course, that's the fancy boys outside. There's been some sterling performances in the engine room as well. The captain, Wamoi Dornal, he's been strong. Also like the work of number 7, Ulu Nakavandra.
Set.
An open side flanker for Fiji. All done their jobs very well without any fuss, those Fijian forwards, that's for sure. Now they're on attack too. They always look so good when they get a sniff on attack, don't they, the Fijians? Kanavere too, he's been good. Kanavere, the hooker for Fiji. Again, solid at scrum count. Reliable at line-out time. And good with ball in hand too.
Okay, boys.
Kanishiri.
Perfect. Yeah. We need to do it.
New man on the flank there for Fiji is Masamila, number 20. months proving how versatile he is, moving him from 10 to scrum high. Calling a move to the backs. Bongi Drought, number 8. Also powerful. Maybe a shoot down the blind side. No, he's going to go open here, months. Mbotitu, skip ball. Vodrongo, he's powerful, Vodrongo. Look at him go, just shrugs off the tacklers. Vodrongo, great individual try, and that could be try of the day there, I think, from the centre. Ilekina Vodrongo. Wow, what a run. Again, similar to Rockhorn Bully's try down the left flank, beating 4 or 5 tacklers, just staying on his feet, so powerful. Wow.
I'll check, but it's around 7.
Looks like we've got a new kicker here too, Tuatanga Nivalu, deciding to hand duties over to Mbotitu.
I think it's 5.
And he's 100% from the tee today then, and 2 tries as well for Philemoni Mbotitu. And he set that try up too with a skip pass to Vodrongo. So we've only got a few minutes left in this World Rugby Trophy final. Samoa has been valiant. They find themselves in arrears, 46 points to 3.
Come on.
As mentioned, their first ever loss at World Cup trophy time, now to 20 level. Well, that's a lovely kickoff.
Backwards.
But again, Fiji taking the ball at crucial times.
Leave it, boys.
Months to Mbotitu. That ball comes off the side of his boot. No one too interested out there on the left with that one. Friendly fire from Mbotitu. Samoa with the chance of a consolation try here. Solomono at the front. He's been great. He's been Samoa's best player for me. Hasn't let up as Fiji. Vodrongo again. He's got the bit between his teeth. Had the taste of one try. Wants another, but Samoa take it quickly. Yeah, that's nice creative camera work there, picking up the ball mid-flight. Rokombuli. So Fiji again on attack.
No, 21, stop, boy!
Mbotitu just showing his skills with the boot, but great counter-attack here from Fui Ono. Well, powerful too. Here's Samoa on the charge. Good work. Can they finish with a flourish? Yong Yen out wide. It's Solomono, the hero for Samoa. Can he get there? Give him the try, I say. Give him the try. He's been full value, that's for sure. Shama Anthony Solomono hasn't stopped trying. Actually played earlier this year for the Samoan under 20 team. Sorry, last year in the Samoan under 20 team at world championship level when they were demoted to the trophy level. Hard to tell on this camera angle. But they've given the try. That's fantastic. He really deserves that, Shama Anthony Solomona. Great to see on a losing effort someone so focused on his own game and doing his basics right and featuring with ball in hand. Before they can't convert from the sideline, but at least Samoa can They'd have scored a try in this final. And it's like a battlefield out there at the moment, isn't there? All sorts of players going down with cramps and niggles and knocks. And that's why we saw some of those players in the stands just relaxing, enjoying, taking in the atmosphere of this final. They've done their duty for their country, that's for sure, over the last week, and made the countries proud too. Great festival of rugby here in Romania. And finally, they'll have a substitution at front row time as Nativa limps off. He's had a good tournament, Emmanuel Nativa. And on comes Mabel Kavulkandru. 3 minutes to go. Mbotito. Oh, that's a great restart. Budongo. He's really coming to his own in the last seconds of this game. Giri Nalangi. Wow. That's a fantastic try from a restart. Fiji. Oh my goodness. And doesn't that encapsulate Fiji and rugby in 5 seconds? I don't know how Budongo made that 20 odd meters in such a great time. The ball didn't hang for very long. What a player Gilekine Budongo is. Oh, please, can we see a replay of that one? Just hard to believe. He got up in the air, plucked the ball down. Here it is. We just see the last of that catch from Budongo. And Dede Nalang, he looked like he'd be bundled into touch. Somehow turned his body while mid-air and dotted the ball down before he was smashed into touch. Quite incredible. He's got that one from this one as well. So two from two from Mbotito. Wow, just wow. You just got to be gobsmacked with some of the skill that's shown by Fijian rugby players. You see it on the sevens field. Some players with Fijian heritage like Waisaki Naholo. They're just freakish sometimes. Months under pressure, but gets the ball wide. Fiji just are not finished here, are they? They've been relentless, merciless against the Samoan team. 53 points to 8, getting into the last minute of this game. And do they have some more tricks up their sleeve? Oh, risky pass, but why not? Really playing a Fijian brand of rugby. Patterson, he's just come off the bench from his sinbinning. Don't forget, the last 10 minutes they've been playing with 14 men. They've had two tries. Again, just the breadth on the ball. It's beautiful to watch, isn't it? Great display here from Fiji. Budongo, nobody can stop him. Oh my goodness, superb play. Oh. Wow. I'm just gobsmacked. And that's just the way to finish, isn't it? A victory. Superb skill here. And the ref's going to talk to the assistant about that little pass inside. If we're going to the other flank here, let's take a look. There's nothing wrong with the pass. I think it's Joseph Ma who got the inside ball in support.
By number 25.
Late tackle.
Yes. 25. Yes. They're just talking about late tackles from Samoa, so it looks like the try will stand.
Okay. Boys, it's the finish of the game. No yellow card, just a penalty only because of the number 25 late tackle. Okay, boys?
So is he going to award the try or not? This is interesting. Didn't seem like anything wrong with the inside ball. Right, he's got the try. That's good. And that's the end of the game. So I think if play had gone on, he would have awarded a penalty to Fiji there at the halfway line. It doesn't matter now, because Mbotito has been so influential in this game, gets the chance to finish it off. He's converted 2 from 2. The last one is right on the touchline. This one 5 metres in. And finally, he misses one. And referee calls time on what has been a quite incredible final of World Rugby Under 20 Trophy 2018. Fiji, a one-sided race for that trophy. Quite incredible performance for them. 58-8 victory. And some amazing, breathtaking rugby played by them. Samoa sadly had no answer to the power, precision, pace and flair of the Fijians. They were brave. A couple of players picked out there from Samoa. Solomona, who scored that consolation try, he was fantastic. But really, there were just so many influential plays from Fiji and players for Fiji that Samoa really could not compete with the quality. And Fiji, they win the trophy. They will go up to the under 20 world champs next year in Argentina, and they've won this trophy. So many players to talk about, starting from the back. Kurangi Nivalu, a try, inserting himself in the line at will. Rocco Mbuli with one great individual effort down the left flank. Budongo, the last 10 minutes, he was everywhere and unstoppable. Mbotito in the midfield, number 12. A couple of tries, a couple of conversions. Months at first five and then into fly half. Kuruboli, Dere Nalangi, the blindside flanker, getting himself a try. And don't forget the captain either, Omoi Gono. Solid, influential figure in the pack as well. So, as the players congratulate each other, good sporting effort at the end of the game. That's what rugby's all about. Take lumps out of each other in that 80 minutes and then get to know your opponents. Part of the beauty of rugby, part of the fabric of rugby that we love so much. So we have the prize giving to come here on the live stream. I'm going to sign off now. Mike Rehu bringing you this game on behalf of World Rugby. Stay with us with all the prize presentations ahead. Final score, Fiji the victors of the Under 20 trophy. And look at those glittering medals. There it is. Beautiful trophy it is too. Fiji winning the final over Samoa. 58-8. Stay with us for the prize presentation.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the presentation party, Mr. Octaviano Ariu, President of Rugby Europe, Mr. Ali Petrache, President of Romania Rugby Union, and Mr. Pompi Evol, Vice President of Romania Rugby Union. În câteva momente, va începe festivitatea de premiere care va fi oficiată de domnul Octaviano Ariu de la Rugby Europe. Domnul Ali Petrache, președintele Federației Române de Rugby și domnul Bombi Ebor, vicepreședintele Federației Române de Rugby.
We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Air Force, Vice President of Romania, Ralph Junior, will be presented silver medals to Samoa. Domnul Pompilie Bors, vicepreședintele de Grație Române de Olimpii, m-a mânat medalile de la cinci echipe Samoa, finalistă competiției.
Isn't that a lovely touch? Two teams coming together in prayer at the end of the game, sharing a camaraderie and fellowship together, now being presented with their medals. The runners-up, Samoa. Happy faces there for Samoa. They've been beaten by a very good team on the day, but hey, they got to the final. Three good wins before that. There's that moustache. Ba'amau Sili. Love that moustache. Solomona, he was great. Player of the day for Samoa for me. Some walking wounded there, of course. One of the last to receive his medal. Players will we see in the future featuring for the Fijian senior team? Quite a few, I'd imagine. There's some superb skill, especially in the back line, but I'll tell you what, that back line couldn't operate the way they did without the work of the forwards. Some very good performances up front for Fiji today as well. Great, Kurang Nivalu. Such a respectful people, the Fijians. Down on the knee as they receive their medal. And I'm sure there'll be some celebrating back in the islands of Fiji as well. We saw them go absolutely crazy when Fiji won the Olympic gold medal. And I'm not sure if the World Rugby officials are quite bemused by the passionate hugs he's getting from sweaty Fijian rugby players on that nice blazer. Well, don't look. Don't look at him. Shortly we'll see the lifting of the trophy. Here he is, the don't look. Caleb Munts, good work from the ex-Hamilton Boys High people. There it is, that's what they've been playing for. The blood, sweat and tears from the last 6 months of build-up training. Came to Romania a couple of weeks ago. Won 3 games to get here, and then to win the final in such superb fashion. Hats off to this Fijian team for Kukka. Vinaka. Two for the coach, the coaching team of Fiji, Perennial Silambu. It's the official coach of Fiji, but of course it's a team effort and the coaching staff as well. Now where's that captain? Like a bullet, Momoi Dono will receive the trophy. And up it goes. Fiji, the victors of the World Rugby Under 20 Trophy Tournament 2018. Get out that old queen favourite. We are the champions soon as well. All good celebration music, isn't it, the Fijians? And I'm sure the party will go on and on this lovely late summer evening in Bucharest as they walk that trophy round, take it to the supporters, I'm sure. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the coverage here from the Stadio Nul, the Arc de Triomphe in Bucharest. It's been a great game, it's been a fantastic tournament for rugby, and on behalf of World Rugby, this is Mike Brady signing off from Bucharest. Enjoy the rest of the live stream, but for me and this hard-working team, giving you the camera shots from Bucharest, it's a very good evening wherever you are around the globe.